गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस आर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज़ इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स. सो बिफोर डूइंग अ चैप्टर वी शैल डिस्कस द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अ राइटर. ए के रामानुजन, ही वॉज एन इंडियन पोइट एंड स्कॉलर ऑफ इंडियन लिटरेचर हु रोट इन बोथ इंग्लिश एंड कन्नड़. द कोलेक्टिव पोइम्स ऑफ ए के रामानुजन रिसीव्ड साहित्य अकेडमी अवार्ड. द स्टोरी इज अ कन्नड़ फोक टेल. अ फोक टेल एज वी ऑल नो is a story which is passed on from one generation to another. It is taken from book Folk Tales from India by Ramanujan. When the fool rule over the kingdom, then what all happens has been told in the story in the kingdom of fools. So let's read. In the kingdom of fools, both the king and minister were idiots. They didn't want to run things like other kings, so they decided to change day into night and night into day. So they ordered that everyone should be awake at night, till their fields and run their businesses only after dark, and go to bed as soon as sun rose up came up. Anyone who disobeyed would be punished with death. So in the kingdom of fools, the king and his minister both were idiots. They didn't want to run their kingdom like others, so they decided to do something different. They started treating night as day and day as night, means the work which was done at night would be done during daytime and day work will be done during night. So nobody would sleep at night. The farmers, businessmen do work at night. As soon as sun rose up, everyone would go to sleep. Denying by someone would be punished with death. So king or minister ne order diya ki unke kingdom of fools mein kya hai, log din mein kya hai soyenge aur raat ke waqt kya hai kaam karenge. Agar kisi ne ye wala order deny kiya, mana kiya isko follow karne mein, to usko kya punishment milegi? Death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. So the people were scared. They obeyed the order. The king and his minister, both the fools, were very happy that people were following their order. One day, a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. Everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring, even the cattle. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. The two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening, when suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly businesses. So one day a saint arrived with one of his disciples. He saw that it is a beautiful city with sunny day, but couldn't find anyone around. They were astonished. They were surprised that not a mouse was stirring, means moving around. That means silence all around. Even animals as well as humans were sleeping. These two strangers, guru and his disciple, were not aware of the order. So they were kept on wandering around in the whole city. And as soon as it was night, everyone woke up and started doing their work. So वो दोनों गुरु और उसका शिष्य दोनों आए, और उन दोनों ने देखा, वो हैरान हो गए इस किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स में क्या है, सभी लोग जो है दिन में कहाँ गए. उनको किंग के ऑर्डर के बारे में कुछ नहीं पता था, और क्या है वो सोचने लगे कि लोग कहाँ गए. इवन अ माउस वॉज नॉट देयर, कि माउस भी और एक इवन टाइनी एनिमल भी वहाँ दिखाई नहीं दे रहा, कि लोग कहाँ गए. और जब रात हुई तो उन्होंने देखा कि लोग जो है काम करना शुरू कर रहे थे. द टू मैन वर हंग्री नाउ दैट द शॉप्स वर ओपन. दे वेंट टू बाय सम ग्रोसरीज. टू देयर एस्टोनिशमेंट दे फाउंड दैट एवरीथिंग कॉस्ट द सेम अ सिंगल दूतू. Whether they bought measure of rice or a bunch of bananas, it cost a dudu. The guru and his disciple were delighted. They had never heard of anything like this. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. So the strangers were hungry. When at night shops were open, they went to buy groceries. Dudu means money in Kannada language. So they were surprised. The things were very cheap there. Whether you buy a big bunch of bananas or rice, bag of rice, all cost it same, one dutu. Everything was at the same price in the kingdom of fools, and both were astonished, surprised to see all this. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that the kingdom of fools, that this was the kingdom of fools, and it wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay there. So the guru realized that kingdom was kingdom of fool, and they decided not to stay there anymore. This is no place for us. Let's go, he said to his disciple. But the disciple didn't want to leave the place. Everything was cheap here. All he wanted was good cheap food. The guru said, they are all fools. This wouldn't last very long, and you can't tell what they will do to you next. So the guru told his disciple, place was not suitable. They had to leave. The disciple was foodie, as he was foodie who loves to eat. Disciple was foodie who loves to eat, didn't want to leave that place because the food was cheap. So the guru tried to make his disciple understand that everything was not suitable. Everyone was fool here. So it's dangerous to stay here anymore. But the disciple wouldn't listen to Guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay. And Guru finally gave up and said, do what you want. I am going, and left. The disciple stayed on and ate his fill every day. Bananas, ghee, rice, wheat, and grew fat like a street side sacred bull. So his disciple couldn't understand and wanted to live there. Finally, Guru left, leaving him behind. The disciple stayed back in the kingdom. Every day he ate. Every disciple ate every day and becomes fat day by day, like a bull. One bright day, thief broke into merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in, and he was carrying out his loot. The wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. So one day, thief entered merchant's house. He made a hole in the wall after looting things. When he was about to leave the wall, the wall broke and fell down on his head, and he died. Now king, एक थीफ, एक चोर है जो मर्चेंट के घर आता है. और क्या है, वो जब चोरी करके वहाँ होल वॉल में होल किया होता है उसने, और उस होल में से जब वो जाने लगता है तो क्या है, वो वॉल सारी है जो टूट के उसके ऊपर गिर जाती है, और क्या है, थीफ की डेथ हो जाती है ऑन द स्पॉट. हिज ब्रदर रैन टू द किंग एंड कंप्लेंड, योर हाइनेस, व्हेन माई ब्रदर वॉज परसुइंग हिज एंशिएंट ट्रेड, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to be blamed. He should have built a good strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for this injustice. So next day, thief's brother complained that his brother was following his ancient trade. He was working. The wall fell on his head. He wanted to take advantage of foolish king. He said merchant was culprit because his wall is cause of death of his brother. सो ही रिक्वेस्टेड टू पनिश मर्चेंट एंड गेट कॉम्पनसेशन। उसका ब्रदर किंग के पास आता है और बोलता है कि उसकी भाई की डेथ का वो हरजाना लेके जाएगा और उसकी डेथ की वजह जो मर्चेंट है उसके हाउस की जो वॉल है उसके ऊपर गिरी है, उसकी डेथ का कारण एक मर्चेंट है, सो मर्चेंट को पनिशमेंट दी जाए। द किंग सेड जस्टिस विल बी डन, डोंट वरी, एट वंस समंड द ओनर ऑफ द हाउस। व्हेन द मर्चेंट अराइव्ड द किंग क्वेश्चन्ड हिम, व्हाट्स योर नेम, सच एंड सच, योर हाइनेस, वर यू एट होम व्हेन द डेड मैन बर्गल्ड योर हाउस, यस माय लॉर्ड, ही ब्रोक इन द वॉल इन एंड द वॉल वॉज वीक, इट फेल ऑन हिम, द अक्यूज्ड प्लीड्स गिल्टी, योर वॉल किल्ड द मैन्स ब्रदर, यू हैव मर्डर्ड अ मैन, वी हैव टू पनिश यू। सो द किंग वॉज फुलिश, he thought man died because of the wall fell on him and the owner had to be punished, so he called the merchant appeared, king asked whether he was at home at the time of theft, merchant replied that he was at home, so thief made hole, and after theft when he would about to leave the house wall fell on his head and they Then the king told the merchant that he was guilty. He did wrong due to his weak wall. The thief died, so he would be punished. So, merchant को बुलाया जाता है, उसको बोला जाता है कि क्या आप चोरी के टाइम घर पे ही थे, और वो बोलता है कि हाँ मैंने अपना ये घर पे ही था और मैंने इंसिडेंट अपनी आँखों से देखा है कि जब वो चोर है वो हॉल से भाग रहा था तो वॉल क्या है उसके ऊपर गिर गई और वो क्या है उसकी डेथ हो गई है, और वो क्या बोलते हैं कि सब तेरी वजह से हुआ है, तू ही क्या है इसका जिम्मेदार है उसकी डेथ का, तेरे को पनिशमेंट दी जाएगी डेथ। नेक्स्ट इज लॉर्ड said the helpless merchant, I didn't put up the wall, it's really the fault of man who built the wall, he didn't build it right, you should punish him, who's that, my lord, this wall was built in my father's time, I know the man, he's an old man now, so and he lives nearby, so the merchant requested that it was not his fault but of the person who made the wall, who constructed, the person was very old now, he knew him, he lived nearby, so